cricketer Mohammed Shami is used to getting his rivals clean bowled. But this time, he was at the receiving end, as his wife rocked all his stumps.
I will teach Shami a lesson for all his misdeeds.
Where did this snowball come from? Suddenly, the life of this pace bowler went into a spin. In Kolkata, in early March, within 3 days of Hasina's complaint,
Shami is being booked under Section 498A of Domestic Violence Act.
Section 498A came into existence in 1983 under the Indian Penal Code and has been praised for giving protection to women who face abuse from husbands and their families.
Tell your father, I want a car!
He beats me. He keeps demanding dowry from my family.
And ridiculed, as women increasingly used it, especially among the middle class and more educated, as a way of blackmailing the husband and his family. If an allegation like this was made within 7 years of marriage, arrest was immediate. After several documented cases of misuse,
misuse of the provision has created a new form of legal terrorism.
Most complaints are filed in the heat of the moment, and children are the worst victims. In 2017, the Supreme Court in the Rajesh Sharma case, no automatic arrest can be made, as women have been abusing the legal provisions.
The complaint must be examined by a committee before arresting anyone.
Take Shami's case. Just weeks before Holi, they appeared to be happy together. Shami has publicly stood up for his wife Hasin Jahan against Islamists who troll them for publicly posting pictures.
My wife and daughter are my life partners, and I know what I can do and what I can't.
But then something went wrong.
He has tortured me. He's a big flirt and womanizer and has been unfaithful to me.
While her accusations of an extramarital affair with a Pakistani model were true or not, there was no need for Hasin Jahan to wash dirty laundry in public. Then, in a bid to stigmatize his entire family, she accused them of 307 attempt to murder, 376 punishment for rape, 506 criminal intimidation, 328 causing hurt by means of poison, and others. Next, she went after Shami's career.
If Mohammed Shami can cheat on me, then he can cheat the country as well. He is involved in match fixing through his Pakistani girlfriend.
The BCCI Committee of Administrators met with the anti-corruption unit head Neeraj Kumar.
You are to submit the report on the charges against Mohammed Shami within 7 days.
It looked as though, at age 27, just when he was maturing to become India's test spearhead, Shami's cricketing career was over. Were he found guilty, he could have lost 8 crore of rupees of fees from BCCI and IPL team Delhi Daredevils for the 2018 season alone, where he anyway played only 4 matches. While Shami may be no angel, his wife appeared nothing better than a gold digger herself. Events took an interesting turn when it was revealed that Hasina had lied on their marriage certificate. ABP News tracked down her earlier husband, Sheikh Saifuddin, a grocer with whom she had had 2 daughters.
She wanted to make it big in life and I was a small man. She divorced me in 2010.
After dumping her husband, Hasina joined as a cheerleader for the IPL, where she caught Shami's roving eye and married him. Soon, BCCI's anti-corruption unit gave Shami a clean chit.
He will be given a grade B annual returnship contract for Team India.
With that out of the way,
I hope to now return to my old routine, get my life back, and just look after the future of my daughter.
Globally, violence between partners cost the world 25 times more than all the wars and terrorism put together. Each assault costs a woman 5.5 days of paid or unpaid domestic work, resulting in a total loss of 13,000 crore or $2 billion to the country. At least 5 crore or 15 million, or almost 1 out of every 4 women in India in the ages of 15 to 49 experience abuse at the hands of their husbands. All marriages go through ups and downs. Problems that cannot be solved within the four walls need to be taken to a professional counselor before escalating it to a crime.
It is common for all couples to go through some problems.
Police, who deal with murder and savage crimes, really have no training in handling delicate domestic matters.
They can analyze medical evidence of a physical beating, but how will they define mental cruelty?
Historically, women have been at the receiving end of matrimonial disputes. But aren't things being taken too far when yesterday's hero Jitendra was booked by the police?
He physically abused me 40 years ago.
Live-in relationships that die a natural death are often dragged to courts.
He promised to marry me, but he did not. He cheated me.
Making women financially independent has been seen to reduce the incidence of domestic violence by half. Nyayadhar, a group of women advocates, protested the 2017 judgment that diluted the law in a bid to stop false arrests.
The judgment could affect the rights of women for whom this law is made.
This July, the Supreme Court will once again hear both sides of the argument and try to put forward a more balanced law. The basic problem in Indian law is that there are no consequences for false allegations. Shami could lose his entire career and reputation even if his wife loses the case. Libel laws should be made stringent like in the US, where an accuser has to pay dearly for false cases. Bisbo's limerick. There's something called Domestic Violence Act, where if you beat your wife, you're gonna get jacked. But now it's being misused and men are being abused. But the women don't want to accept this fact. All our videos are based on news and information published in leading international newspapers, magazines, professional journals and news channels, which we represent in a fun and interesting way. We pride ourselves on being a source of authentic news and information.